Hi again, everyone. Welcome to another episode of RV Business Capital Talk, sponsored by Ericsell. I'm Rick Kessler. With me, Sherman Goldenberg, and joining the two of us today is Ryan Brady. Ryan, of course, with his brother Coley, are co-founders of Alliance RV back in 2019, which doesn't seem possible, but that's 5 years ago now. That's crazy.
Yeah, it's wild. Sometimes I drive in and kind of pinch myself that it's been 5 years. Sometimes it feels like it's been 18 months. Other times it feels like 15 years.
Well, Alliance RV, of course, based in Elkhart, a huge campus going, growing campus too, by the way, over there on the east side of Elkhart, right up the street from Sherman's favorite lunch spot, Sports Time Bar and Grill.
Very cheeseburger. Nice. Frequent it often, know it well.
You guys, one of the things I wanted to ask you about, and maybe let's set the stage here. You guys are a towable manufacturer, started with fifth wheels. Now you're into travel trailers with the Delta. You hit the market right at the peak of COVID. Now we're on the downside and we're in a downturn. How's things going over at Alliance? How's this market treating you guys?
Yeah, no, it's, you know, we mentioned, feel like we've seen a lot, right? We started in 2019 and shortly thereafter the COVID period hit. And with that came some challenges in terms of supply chain and then, you know, keeping up with the demand. And then post-COVID, you know, the slowdown that we've all experienced over the last 2 years. But, you know, it's been good. We've been fortunate. We have a fantastic team here at Alliance RV, 650 people strong. We feel like our culture, which is a, you know, a key differentiator, a key competitive advantage, is incredibly strong. We have a great team around us. You know, we've been very deliberate and methodical with our growth. We've really kind of limited ourselves to one brand launch per year. We launched with the Paradigm in 2019, 2020, the Valor in 21, the Avenue in 22, and then the most recent brand launch, our travel trailer in 23. And yeah, it's been good. You know, the last 24 months have certainly been a challenge, but you know, we feel good as a company. You know, our thesis was when things slowed down that there would be, you know, kind of this flight to quality, right? Dealers would be, you know, more deliberate, more disconcerting with the brands that they were going to stock, you know, brands where, you know, the design features were there, where they could hold a fair margin, where the quality was there, where the support was there on the back end. And we feel like we're one of those brands and we've been the beneficiary of that. And that's shown up through market share gains. You know, we look at the most recent stat survey report that I think is through February, and all of our brands are taking share. So we feel good, but, you know, we're not caught up in the, you know, the monthly market share movements. You know, we're playing the long game, and, you know, we're passionate about taking care of our dealers and our customers. And we feel if we continue to do that, you know, good things will happen. We can't control the overall industry, whether 350,000 units are going to be sold or 600,000, but we can control our controllables, and that's what we're going to continue to do.
Very good.
Your strengths, 30,000 foot view of your company and your strengths, what are they? What are you best at?
I would say we're best at, you know, culture. You know, I think any organization, it's all about the team. And when we attract a talented, you know, workforce that's passionate about what they do, you know, good things will happen. We're, I think we're innovative in terms of how we design our RVs. You know, we kind of coined the term, you know, it's crowdsourcing, right? So we get on the social media pages, we talk to RVers, we go to the shows, we go to the campgrounds, we try to just listen and find areas, you know, opportunities to improve the design of the RV. And then, you know, we try to provide a better ownership experience. You know, we use our size and our nimbleness to our advantage. You know, we're in close contact with our dealer partners, with our end retail customers. We try to be uber transparent, uber accessible for that end retail customer to address any issues and concerns. And we tell people, you know, there's no perfect RV. These are rolling homes. It's not if, it's when a service need is going to arise with your RV. And when you buy an Alliance RV, you have the peace of mind of knowing you're buying from a manufacturer that's going to support you on the back end.
Very good. Ryan, you mentioned it, and that's innovation. You guys, you and Coley just had a video come out on innovation. There's a couple of really cool nuggets that I pulled from that, and that is the rain bay, the shaker table, and using laser equipment to make sure you get your sidewalls correct. Not cheap improvements you're putting there.
No, not at all. Again, it's taking that long-term approach. And, one of our core values is relentless improvement. And we identify these areas as areas where we can improve. And so the rain bay is a great tool. You know, we're running, I think we're up to 6 rigs per day that we're rolling in there. I think it's about 30 to 45 minutes per test. We've uncovered some stuff, I'll be honest, through that process. Shaker table, same deal there. If we can eliminate some, shakedown that arrives at the dealership, identify some loose trims, some components that, need to be better secured, great opportunity there. And then from a lamination standpoint, the laser table is really just to avoid any, miscues as it relates to backers, just making sure the placements are there correctly to, again, avoid any miscues. And it's more of a demonstration of our long-term commitment. We're not playing the short game. We're building the brand, right? We're building a company. And these are, while they're expensive, we view them as necessary. And ultimately, there's going to be a return on it.
Yeah.
Sitting here in this, what Rick calls a downturn, when you sit down to plan product development, you have these conflicting market forces right now. We read one headline, it's about how towables are getting smaller, that the most popular, we're looking at smaller trailers and less expensive. Yet, if you're taking the long game, if you're doing the long game, it's not all going to little trailers, is it?
No, I don't think so. I mean, we launched with the Paradigm, the big fifth wheel, the Valor as well. And there's, within any segment, I think we've all been in this game long enough, there's going to be ebbs and flows within product categories, but there's still going to be a market for high-end fifth wheels. And, we want to participate in that, and we want to be very competitive and design and build a really great, product within that category. And so we're believers in really all the categories that we play in, and we don't get caught up again in the noise and the what's hot at the moment. We just try to execute in the categories that we're in.
Well, that I wouldn't be doing my job if I didn't ask this question, but please spill the beans as far as product. What are you guys working on for this year?
Yeah, no, we're always busy, but obviously, we got the open house coming up in a few months here. And I think the theme this year will kind of be just rounding out some of our product categories. Delta being our most recent launch, we're going to be coming out with a newer trim level. It's going to be branded underneath the Delta, but it'll hit, I guess, to Sherm's point, a smaller category, slightly lower price point. The Avenue mid-profile fifth wheel. We're going to be rounding out some floor plans there. We have the All Access, which is again, I guess, targeted to the that shorter, more of a half ton tow vehicle. A couple new neat floor plans coming out there, and we're actually launching a travel trailer underneath the Avenue brand as well. So we're going to be rounding out that brand. And then there's one other project, can't disclose just yet, but that will be coming at Open House as well, that we're working very hard on. We're going to be excited to share more details when the time's right.
Beautiful. The Avenue trailer, will that be big brother to the Delta then?
It will be. Yeah. So it's going to be, longer, generally more slides, a bigger floor plan than what we currently offer in the Delta lineup.
Well, congratulations. Yeah. What's
that?
Well, you're not sitting still, that's for sure.
No, absolutely not. And then, within Avenue and Paradigm, or I'm sorry, within Valor and Paradigm, a couple of new exciting floor plans and some other neat changes that will be coming down the pike there as well. So yeah, we're not stagnant. we're not sitting on past success. We're constantly driving product here.
The other thing I wanted, oh, I'm sorry, go Sherm.
Oh, you go.
I wanted to ask you before I forgot, because I almost did. You guys were just in Arkansas. You just had a grand opening. Tell us about that, because I believe it was with Camping World. Is that right?
It was, yeah. We partnered with Camping World. They approached us 6 to 9 months ago about the concept. And yeah, we believe in the concept. It's, in our opinion, you know, the shopping experience that it provides. You know, we had, I think, every single floor plan that we build on display at the dealership.
And Ryan, just to be clear, we're talking about an Alliance exclusive or brand exclusive store, OEM exclusive store.
OEM exclusive within our category. So I think, okay. You know, within the entry level, you know, stick and tin category, you know, we don't participate in that just yet. So they did have a product offering there. We're obviously not in the motorized segment. So, you know, it's conceivable they'll sell some motorized brands out of there as well. But for the most part, yeah, you know, it's primarily an Alliance store and it's kind of branded as such. And, you know, it's a neat concept and, you know, we're in the early innings of it, but excited to see how it plays out.
That's pretty fascinating partnership.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sherm, you had a question that I interrupted you on?
Well, I wanted to save it up there. You go ahead, Rick, for the moment. I want to make it my last question.
Okay.
We're not quite there yet.
Ryan, we talked a little bit about your campus over there in Elkhart. You're approaching what, 800,000 or so manufacturing square feet of manufacturing space?
Manufacturing and sub-assembly and parts and warranty. So 800,000 total square feet under roof, approximately.
Okay.
And how many buildings?
So we'll have five manufacturing lines under four roofs. We have our lamination plant, and then we have five sub-assembly plants. So we have a HR accounting building with some fabrication for maintenance, parts and service, and we do a CNC shop. So it's a pretty extensive campus, as you guys know, from being out here.
Well, and with room to grow, right?
Yes, we were able to grab some land. I think it was about 12, 18 months ago. So we have plenty of acreage to support future growth, which, you know, back to the culture, we think there's significant value to having a, you know, one contiguous, you know, campus here where all of our plants are, you know, really within walking distance. You know, that's important to Coley and I and the rest of the senior team is, you know, we're in these plants. When we're in town, we're in there every single day. And, you know, talking to our team and, you know, keeping them up to speed with where things are going and how the market's doing, which I think, you know, they appreciate.
Yeah.
And the fact that we're interviewing you by yourself, Coley still with the company?
Absolutely. He, you know, he's probably out in a plant or in a product meeting as we speak. He's doing the next one. He couldn't make today's capital talk.
All right. So my final question.
Yes.
I was marveling at the shaker table and this concept, which is, you know, for the viewer, what? It does what? I mean, I think I know, but in your words.
It mimics the initial transportation from the from here in Elkhart to the dealer. And so, you know, it's trying to mimic just that, right? Not all roads are perfect. You're going to encounter some potholes and some bad roads out there, which could lead to some issues within the RV. So we're trying to identify those issues before the rig ships out. So when we first started, we did a test drive and all the products that we were building. We drove them around our campus and, you know, tried to beat them up pretty good. And then we'd open them up and see what we find and try to do better the next time. And really it's from a cleanliness standpoint too, is where there's some value in it. So as we've grown, the sustainability of test driving, you know, 30 to 40 RVs a day wasn't, you know, sustainable. So this helps us, you know, do that test drive per se in a more efficient manner.
So here's my question. Did you ever ride on the shaker table?
I didn't see it, but as the story goes, the initial shake on the shaker table was a little too rigorous and we had to turn it down just a little bit. We it was a little too much, but no, it's a, But if you see it, Sherm, I'll show it to you next time you come out. It's pretty cool, and it'll get your attention.
I may want to ride too.
All right. I don't know if we'll let you in there, but after you see it, you may not want to go in there.
All right. Thank you. Thank you for joining us, Ryan.
Yeah, appreciate it, guys.
Yep. Ryan, thank you so much. And thanks again to Eric Sell for their continued sponsorship. And until next time, we will see you down the road.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
Take care.